Hello friends, welcome to my channel Tutor, and today we are going to study about the second law of motion. Now till now we have done the force, we have discussed about force, we have also discussed about the first law of motion. Now what basically is the second law of motion? So second law of motion says that the force applied on an object is directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. So this is basically the second law. As I have said earlier also, I would prefer if you will go by the law which is mentioned in the NCERT word by word, because we do not tweak law according to us, we say it exactly as it is. Now here the new term that you can see is the momentum. Momentum is basically the power of the motion. It is given by the product of the mass and the velocity. It is represented by letter P and it's written as small p, not capital P. Okay, now since velocity, it's a vector quantity, right? It has both direction as well as magnitude associated with it. So momentum is also a vector quantity. That means it has both the magnitude as well as the direction. The direction is the same as that of the direction of the velocity. So I can write this as P is equal to mv, right? Now in this case, there are two things that arises. First of all, this means that momentum is directly proportional to the mass and momentum is directly proportional to the velocity. Now I'll explain to you what this means. So if there is a truck and there is a small car, the truck obviously has a greater mass, right? So that means if both of them goes with the same velocity, then a truck will have greater momentum as compared to that of the car, right? Now second is the velocity. For example, if you have a bullet and there is a ball, right? So what we are going to consider is let both of them be of the same mass. Let one be a crazy ball and one would be a bullet, fine? One is traveling with greater speed. Let the bullet travel with a much greater velocity as compared to that of the ball. And if I hit a person, I don't plan to, but if I hit a person with both the things, then the person will get injured with the bullet and not with the ball. This is because it has more velocity, and since the velocity is more, so the momentum is more, hence the force that is applied on the person will be more. This is the statement. Now few of the questions that come on this is, for example, what will be the momentum if my mass is doubled? Now in that case, there's a very simple way to do this. Now initially I'll say that my P1 is equal to M1V1. This is my initial momentum is equal to initial mass times velocity. This is fixed. Now the person says in the question it is said that my new mass, that is the mass, it gets doubled. That means it becomes twice of the original mass. Yes? So now what will be the my final momentum? My final momentum will be P2 is equal to M2. And since it says that my mass has increased, it says nothing about the velocity. So I'll keep my velocity as same. So it will be M2V1. And now what I'll do is I'll substitute this value of M2. This value here in this equation, and with that what I'll get is 2m2 in place of m2 I'll write 2m1 v1, which is equal to 2m1 v1. Now from here I can see that m1 v1 is p1, right? So what I'll do is I'll replace this m1 v1 with the p1, and thus I will get 2p1. This is a very simple way to do these type of questions. For example, if the question had been that, you know, the mass is reduced by half, and let's say that my velocity becomes 3 times. So I'll write it like this. Now in this equation, since my velocity is changing, so this will become V2. It will not be the same as V1, right? What I'll do next is I'll replace the value. So M2 here, now what I have as M2, M2 is M1 by 2 and V2 is 3V1. So next what I'll get is 3 in the numerator and 2 in the denominator, right? See, 3 here and 2 here. So 3 in the numerator and 2 in the denominator, and M1 and V1. So this M1, V1 will be replaced by P1 and I will get 3 by 2. It's a very simple way to find this. Very simple way. Now, since momentum is a mass times velocity, what do you think is the SI unit of this? For mass, the SI unit is kg, and for velocity, I have it as meter per second. So, the unit for momentum is kg meter per second. There is a very simple trick to find the unit if you need to. I'll just explain it to you. How can you find the unit and what does this mean? Fine. Now, let's quickly focus this before I rub this off. So, the force applied on an object is directly proportional. So, that means that the force that is applied on an object is directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. So, it's directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. Focus on this sentence and we will come back to this. Okay? Now, before I begin with the second law, let me explain how you can derive the SI units. It's a very simple formula we have. Now, see, the formula said that P equals mv, right? So, in this case, what is my unit of velocity? You don't need to remember anything. Don't ratify anything. So, v is basically, what is velocity? Velocity is basically speed with direction, right? So, speed is distance divided by time. Now, what is the SI unit of distance? It is meter, right? And for time, we have seconds. So, the unit of velocity is meter per second. You can put meter per second here. And for mass, what is the unit? Kg. You measure the mass of anything in kg, right? So, the unit of momentum would be kg. Now, in the numerator, I have kg and meter. So, the unit of velocity will be kg meter. And in the denominator, I have seconds. So, I put second. This is my unit for momentum, right? Now, let's get back to the second law of momentum, of motion. So, now, according to the second law of motion, the statement said that force is directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. Now, I have said this in earlier class as well. As soon as you see the word rate of, so rate of means that divided by dt. For example, in the case of acceleration, it is the rate of the change of the velocity. So, you write A equals velocity, change in the velocity, divided by the time taken. Yes? So, I will have for force, I'll put F directly proportional to. Since it says rate of, so in the denominator, I will have time and change of momentum. In the numerator, I will have change of momentum. Now, what is this change of momentum? Change of momentum basically means that it is final momentum, let this be Pf or I can say P2, minus the initial momentum, that is Pi divided by t, right? Now, what is my final momentum? So, final momentum or Pf. Now, we already know the formula for a momentum, that is mass into velocity. So, Pf would be, since we are talking about the same object, so the mass will be same, that is m. And final velocity, mass into velocity, what is the final velocity written as? V, right? Similarly, for initial momentum, now for momentum, we have the momentum is equal to mass into velocity, right? So, my initial momentum, that is Pi, would be mass times initial velocity. Now, initial velocity is written by u, right? I'll replace these Pf and Pi here. So, what I'll get is mv minus mu divided by t. Now, here you can see that this m and this m, can I say that they are common? They are on both the sides. So, I will take m as common and inside I will get v minus u divided by t. Now, if you remember, a equals v minus u by t. Do you remember this? Right? For the acceleration, this was the formula. This is also the first equation of motion, right? So, I will replace this v minus u by t. Can you see this v minus u by t? And can you see this v minus u by t? So, what I'll do is, I'll replace that v minus u by t by this a. What I will get is, from this equation, I will get f is directly proportional to ma. Now, if I need to remove this proportionality sign, what I need to do, I'll put equal to, and then a constant of proportionality, and then ma. Simple. This is the equation that I have. We are doing the derivation of the second law of motion. Now, if I have a force of 1 Newton acting on a body of 1 kg, then the acceleration that the body will suffer is 1 meter per second square. So I'll replace F with 1, K I do not know the value, mass is 1 kg and acceleration is 1 meter per second square. So from here I'll get the value of K as 1 and I'll replace in this and I will get the equation as F is equal to ma. This is also my second law of Newton's second law equation. Now according to this, the force applied on an object is the product of the mass and the acceleration of the body. From here what next I can get is A equals F by M. That means acceleration is directly proportional to the force that is applied on an object and is inversely proportional to the mass. So as the force applied on a body increases, the acceleration will increase. You must have seen this. Also, as the mass increases, the acceleration decreases. This is the reason why it's easier to move a small car with your hand with a much greater acceleration as compared to a big truck with your hand when you apply the same force. I hope this is clear to you. Acceleration is directly proportional to the force and is inversely proportional to the mass. Also, what do you think is the SI unit of this acceleration? Now for force, the unit is Newton and for mass, I have kg. So one of the unit is this one. Other unit for this is, now for example, if I take it from here only. So rate of change of momentum, that means for momentum, the unit was kg meter per second. And if I have time, it will be square. So the unit of force is kg meter per second square also. So for A equals F by M, let's find the value. See, it's very easy. For one function, there can be multiple values. So for force, I have kg meter per second square. And for mass, I have kg again. I'll cancel these two kgs. And thus, the unit of acceleration that I'll get is meter per second square. You must have seen this. Yes? I hope this is clear to you. If you have any doubt, please do let me know in the comment section. Next, we will be doing few questions, numerical questions related to this topic where we will be using all of these formulas that we have just derived. Please stay tuned, stay connected. Bye.